Hello friends, welcome back to I Made Me Think, Cucumber tutorials for BDD with Java. And let's continue this session. As a part of agenda, we will continue from Maven base runner file and all other next slides. So basic project structure I have explained in earlier video, and in this video let's understand the Cucumber options. So Cucumber options can be found in this particular link. So what are the import statements? So run with and cucumber. So this is a runner file in which I have imported a couple of methods and libraries. So we have something called run with and cucumber option cucumber. So run with is a annotation which is in JUnit. So basically it is an interface and it needs a class to run with. So I have provided cucumber.class. So cucumber class, basically there's no main method concept in Maven based project. So cucumber will, Maven will pass control to run with, and run with will pass control to cucumber, and cucumber with cucumber options will pass the scenarios, and then it will pass the control to the actual step definition and step implementation, and so and so and so forth. So let us understand different cucumber options. So feature is something. So if let's say in a complex project we have many feature files, so we can specify which all feature files we need to pass. So to run individual feature file, just say that feature equal to and path of a simple any one feature file. Similarly, these were the other examples, like earlier videos I have run for this or feature 2 or feature 3. To run list of feature files, we can specify them as a list, as an array basically. So feature file dot feature and file 2 dot feature, separated by a comma. So in this case it will run only these two feature files and nothing else. Now to run all feature files under a particular folder, so now I have this folder and I want to run all the feature files which are under this folder, so I can specify like this. So src test resources, and then after that whatever is there it will just execute from that particular folder all the feature files. To run all feature files under a list of folders, so if let's say there are multiple folders under which there are multiple feature files. So let's say for example in under resources we have feature 1 module 1 folder, module 2 folder, module 3 folder, and each module have let's say 2 or 3 feature files, and I want to run all the feature files for module 1 and module 2. So this way I can specify the list of folders under which all the feature files will be executed, will be considered. So as of now, let's run it using this, all the feature files which are under this main resource folder. Now strict tag, a strict option. So what is this? So strict option, if it is true, that means to fail the test case if step is not implemented. If it is false means to pass the test case if step is not implemented. So in earlier video, as we have seen, for couple of steps, the cucumber steps or the gherkin steps, the implementation is not done. I haven't written any code for that. So what happens is, if you say strict equal to true, then if the step is not implemented, the entire test will be failed. And if you set it to false, that means even if the step is not implemented, just continue, or just pass the test and continue, don't fail the entire test cases. We will see this with an example. So strict equal to false, so strict equal to true, we will see strict equal to true. So I have this feature file in which, as we have seen, for this step there is no step implementation, and I have set strict equal to true means the test will fail. Now let's see what happens. if you see the build failure, that means it will say that there is no step for this particular, because I have set it to true and the step is not implemented for this particular step, so the build has failed. So now let's make it as true, let's make it as false and run it once again. Okay, now if you see it mentioned here that you can implement the missing step, that's good, but the build has not failed, so build has succeeded. Okay, so for now I don't need this, and this also I don't need as of now. Next option, monochrome. So for CI/CD environment, for example, if you're running this Maven build on Jenkins, which supports color output of logs. So for example, say for fail, it will be in red, for pass, it will be in green and like that. So if you say monochrome equal to true, that means there will not be any colored output. If you say monochrome equal to false, that means it will show color output. Now we'll see a difference here. So for now, if you, let's say, so far we have seen for true. So if you see for true, this particular step, pass, fail, everything, if you see, it's although you will not see any colored output here, but yeah, so if you see this, it's all clear, there is no extra junk characters and it is not in color. Now what I'll do is I'll just make it as false and let's run it once again. So ideally in the CI/CD environment, if you run it using false and that particular Jenkins version has some plugin or something which is implemented so that it will show colored output, it will be shown like this. The difference is, if you see here, if you see the special characters, so as of now this console output does not support any color output, and that's why this is something called, these are the junk characters which are appearing if you see a monochrome output. But if you see color, if you see anywhere where it supports color logs or color prints, colored output, then this will be in a different color, this will not be in black. So as of now it's let's make it as true. What is a plugin tag or plugin feature? So this is mainly for the reporting purpose, and if you some elaborated or decorated console output, then this is the option we can specify. So pretty, so if you see without pretty, if you see this console output, so these are the steps, these are the steps, these are the basically step implementation, and if you see on the right hand side, there is nothing extra line, no extra line here. Now let's say if I make it as pretty, I enable this and we'll run it once again and let's see the output. If you see here, now these are the additional prints it has done. Basically it has something called pretty. So pretty means it will show in a elaborated or enhanced manner. Now for each step, it will, yeah, so for each step here, so it will show like which method, so from where it has started. So it's basically good for debugging and some pretty format so that anybody, everybody can see what is happening. So for example, so given so and so, so this particular given this, so there's a step definition for this and where is the function call and the line number, it will show the line number, to show this line number. So for pretty, this is the functionality. Then cucumber, to see HTML target, target cucumber to see execution report in HTML format. So open index.html file. So this is again a good feature. So what happens is, if the test cases we execute using Maven and then we want to see a report in kind of a HTML format or in a better format other than the simply looking at logs, so we can specify this. And what happens is, when the Maven runs all these programs, it will generate a report. So this particular thing is available under target folder and cucumber folder. So if you see this a folder called target, so I did run this program, then just refresh. So now you will see there are some other outputs here. So target/cucumber, and here we need to just open this HTML file. So now if you see, this is a kind of a improved way of reports, wherein it says that particular scenario has passed or failed. So now everything is green here, that means no scenario has failed, no scenario was skipped and all the stuff. So let's see one example where I have one scenario which will fail, and then we will see a different output. So feature file 3 has one, this particular scenario which will always fail because I have put a assert statement inside that. So step which failed. Now let's run it once again and let's see. You see build failure and step which failed. So this particular step has some additional statements which will say that this step is the functionality is not working properly for this particular step, so it failed. So now I have added this just to see the different functionality, how to see a different output. So I have just refreshed it so that it will take the latest report. And now if you see, it has, so for this scenario, these are the steps, or for this scenario basically this particular step has failed, and it will show it in a different color. It will show it in a red color, pink color, so that we can understand it. So HTML cucumber and cucumber JSON. So what happens is basically cucumber JSON. So when Maven runs the program, and for each particular test case pass or fail or whatever status, it will put it in a .json file, for which I have mentioned the path here. So cucumber/cucumber.json. So this is the cucumber.json file. So in the JSON file, for particular line, what is the pass or fail? For particular line, what is the pass or fail status? It will mention it in JSON. So line 10, line 12. Status as pass, so and so. So this, why this JSON is required, which we will see in the next session, where we'll see some enhanced kind of reporting, which is not only a simple index.html, but we will see different graphs and different charts. So again, it is a little more enhanced and easy to understand the output. Now let's come to the tags. So tags are used to filter specific tests. So strict, we have seen monochrome, this pretty HTML and format we will see. Then this is the tags. So what is tag? So tags are used to filter specific tests. So let's say there are multiple modules, and in multiple modules there are multiple features, so multiple feature files, and one feature file may contain, let's say, 10 scenarios for example. So out of all these scenarios, if I want to filter it, so let's say I want to run all the test cases on Google Chrome browser and for this particular application, so what I will do is I will put a tag on each and every scenario. So for tags, all these tags related example are in feature file 3. So let me run consider feature file 3. Okay, I'm already considering feature file 3. So tags. So in feature file 3, all the scenarios which are marked here, so if you see there are different tags, we can put some meaningful name. So I have, for demo purpose, I have mentioned different tags. So this scenario has multiple tags, and all these particular scenarios has some tag. This particular step without tag, so this particular scenario has no tag. So let me comment out this. I don't want any failed result for now. So couple of scenarios with tag, couple of scenarios with double tag or multiple tag, couple of scenarios without any tag. Okay, so now if I run it like this, that means it will run all the scenarios from any of the feature file which are considered. So the what feature file to be considered, that I will pass it here. So I can specify one feature file, or I can specify multiple feature file or a folder or multiple folder. So as of now, let's consider only one file. And so in that one file, I want to run all the scenarios which have at least one tag called tag one. So it will execute all the tag, all the scenarios having this tag. If there is no tag for a scenario, it will not execute that. Okay, let's see the sample output. So it has executed only one scenario, that is called step with tag one. Similarly, I don't want to execute anything which is having this tag called tag one. So it is like not conditions, everything else with or without tag, but not tag one. So it will execute from this feature file, except this scenario, it will execute all other scenarios. So all other scenarios means these all, including this. Now if you see, this is not tag one, this is not tag one, this is not tag one, this is not tag one. This, although there is no tag, that means that it has no tag. So it is having no tag one. So this will also execute. Now what is this? OR conditions, logical OR condition. So this will execute all the scenarios with either this or this or this. Now the point here is, if you see tag 22, so the condition is any of the tags should be tagged, or any of the scenarios which is having at least this particular tag, it will just execute. So if you see, tag 22 is present for this, and this is having multiple tags, but still this will execute because this is the logical OR condition. So now if you see tag 6, so there is no scenario which is tagged with a tag called tag 6. So everything is tag 1 to tag 4, 11 and 22. So still it will execute for tag 1 and 22 alone, and it will ignore this because this is not present. Now this is logical AND condition. So I want all the scenarios which are marked with tag 1 and tag 22, both those should be executed, nothing else. Tag 1 and tag 2. So this is again an AND example where I have three tags. Now if you see, tag 1 is at least somewhere, tag 22 is somewhere, but there is no tag 6. So in order to, when this gets executed, this will look for any scenario which is having all these three tags at a time. If all these three tags are not present for one scenario, it will not execute. So this for this particular case, there will be zero matching scenarios. So now let us see what is glue. So this runner class, whatever we have implemented, whatever we have mentioned it here, so runner class will only know that it has to run with Cucumber class. But then it will run with Cucumber class, and Cucumber class will see that where are the feature files. It will go here and look out for the feature files. Okay, now where is the definition of this particular, where is the definition of all the scenarios which are considered using this? So step definition is under this particular module or this particular package. So that is what I need to mention here as a glue. So what Cucumber will, cucumber.class, all this functionality, what it will do is it will match the Cucumber steps with the implementation or the corresponding Java implementation. So I need to mark the glue as package name, basically this package name step and until this. So if you, that means that for all the step definition for all the scenarios under this folder or for this particular feature file are glued with this particular tag or this particular value. So it will just go here in this package, it will open this Java file and it will look for the corresponding matching. If it not implemented or if implemented, it will just start executing. Passing tags from Eclipse or run configuration. So in the run configuration also we have something called parameter passing. So here what we can do is, so for this particular project Cucumber, just open this parameter and pass it like this. So I can pass it like this and it will still execute. So for now I don't want to do this and I want to go via this particular way, so that is also fine. Or using command line also, if you go to command prompt and then say maven clean test and then you want to pass on some parameters, so that time you can go for this minus the cucumber options and whatever tag you want. Parallel test execution, so this is again an interesting topic. So quickly I will do some adjustments. So I have another runner file which is basically for feature 3 and all other parameters are almost the same, and this is the main feature file which I will execute it for, let's say simple. So this feature file is running for this this runner file is for this feature file and this runner file is for this feature file number 3. Now we can run the test parallelly, so we have multiple runner files, so we can just specify multiple runner file in pom file and then we can run this in parallel. So this way we will save the time. So let's open the pom file. For now, so how to specify multiple runner files? So we have this plugin called Maven Surefire plugin, and in which we can specify what are the runner files we want to include. So as of now in this case I am just running only one runner file. If you want to run multiple runner file, so just comment this and it will run multiple runner file. So as of now it will run the runner file in sequence. It is doing it will run multiple files but it will run in sequence. Now this can, I can also do it like this. So I will have to just comment out this line and I can just specify a star here. So in this way I am just running putting a star.java, so that means it will run, it will go to any folder which where there are master runner file underscore any pattern.java, and it will just execute. But in this case also it will, as of now, it will run it in sequence but not in parallel. So how to do it in parallel is, so there's something called fork count. So there's something called fork count and reuse fork. So what it will do is it will run multiple instances for this Maven program, and how many number of instances can be run is using this count, and just say reuse is equal to 2, reuse fork is equal to 2. So multiple runner files using Maven Surefire plugin, and this particular tags we need to use, and include runner file combination, whatever I've shown just now. Now let's run this and see what happens. So I'm running scenario, so simple feature file this one and simple feature file 3 in parallel. Now if you see this output, so this output is coming from one feature file and this is coming from another. So zero scenario is matching. So in this, so let's comment out this tags. Let's run it once again and see. You see there are multiple delays. So I have in one particular scenario of in each feature file there are some delays. So that is why if you run it in sequence it will show case simple in one in first place, and then case two in one place in one sequence. Now since both are running parallel and both are having, in one of the scenarios I put a delay of 1 second, so every time, so these are running actually in parallel, that is what I wanted to specify here. So this way we can achieve some parallelism. Now reporting, so we have seen the advanced, we have seen the normal reporting using logs, we have seen the reporting using index.html, but we have some other plugins available, other Maven plugins available in which we have some advanced reporting. So we can see this in graph, and this kind of graphs will be, you know, kind of an advanced level of to see the report in a proper manner. So results shown in graphical format, use additional plugin in POM file called Maven Cucumber Reporting. It works by generating HTML from the Cucumber JSON report formatter. So as we have seen here, when normal report is getting generated in the runner file, we will specify cucumber.json and then it will generate a cucumber.json here. And so the additional plugin what we have discussed here, the Maven Cucumber Reporting plugin, will use this particular Cucumber JSON and it will show a nice report. So for this, again, I have a different project. This is also available in GitHub repository. So again, we have runner files here. This is again a very simple project where I have considered different tags and two feature files. What I will do is, as of now, I will just delete this target folder. And okay. Now let's run this. So this particular so let's see the POM file here. So here there are some slight changes. So I'm just using 1.2.5 version info cukes and JUnit version, and just one runner file just to show the report for point. And we have to use this additional plugin called from net master thought, and Maven cucumber reporting is the artifact ID. And here we need to specify the internal details, project name, the directory for where it will output the actual HTML file and reports, and which JSON it should consider as an input, and build number, and some other parameters. So let's run this. This is basically running Maven clean test, and no parameters, nothing, and it will just execute a couple of scenarios from this feature file. Okay, the build has failed because one particular step is failed. So these are some feature files, for example, for a home page test. I'm just doing a home user login, change address, and some other browser compatibility test. And in this feature file, the user logout. So this particular step I have failed purposefully so that I can show in the reports how the failed test looks like. So I'm running this runner file, and which will run two feature files, and let's see the output now. So we have already run this. Now just refresh this and you will see a target folder here, so where the reports are generated. So output directory is in site cucumber report advanced. So target site cucumber report advanced, and here we need to see feature overview.html. Now if you see this, let me just open it in a different browser. You can open it in Eclipse as well, but in a browser it looks good. But here also, if you can see, this is a nicer format of output that you will see in graphs, and you will see in this kind of a table structure. So there are different ways you can see. So now if you see, you can see it using feature or tag and steps. So feature wise, there are two feature files. So if you see, there are two rows here, and you will see this graph. So feature statistics, click here. This is for features, steps, and scenario. So you will see a nice graph. Now if you see, in here I've used home page test as a tag, and here I have used home page test other as a tag, and this has not had no tag, and this test will be failed, this particular step will be failed. So in the tags section, you see a nice graph will be shown. It will show that for this particular tag everything is green, and for home page test other tag, one is failed and four are passed. So again, you will see tabular structure here. So this is failed. If you click here also, it will give you, take you to that particular place where you will see a little detailed analysis. So you will see some console output here, whatever, which step has failed and all the stuff. So if you go to steps here also, whatever number of steps are were used for all two feature files, so that breakup it will give. So this is an kind of an advanced reporting where you will see in a graphical structure, and which is very nice to see the output is rather than just looking at the console output logs or just looking at the index.html. So this is again a additional good thing. This project is entire source code is available in GitHub, and I will put the links to the source code in the comment section. At the last, so Gherkin supports not only English but many other native languages such as French, Finnish, and Hindi, Gujarati, Tamil. So we can go ahead and refer to this particular link where we'll find more details. So for more exciting videos, please like, comment, and share my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.